What's going on, ladies and gentlemen, over on the Team Hydra Clan channel? My name is Rocky Cinema, or you can just call me Hydra Rockies, the leader over here on the Team Hydra Clan channel. Now, today what you guys are going to be watching in the background is going to be a pretty quick ASM1 DNA bomb brought to you guys by myself. I know it might not be the best gameplay in the world, but we definitely need to get some more consistent uploads going on. And quick little hint, we're probably going to have a recruitment challenge going on in the next week or two, so stay tuned for that. I'm not sure exactly when it's going to be out yet, but I'm pretty sure we're going to have one. So, you know, stay tuned for that. I apologize if there's any buzzing or static going on in the background. For some reason, my PlayStation is really fucking loud right now. Like, the fan in my PlayStation 4 is really loud, and I don't know why. I might need to get that checked out because it might be overheating or something, but it's really loud lately, and I don't know why. But anyways, be sure to check me out in the description down below, guys. I am the commentator as well as the man behind the gameplay. I'm really close to 1K subscribers. That's my year-end goal, so any help you guys could give me to get there would be much appreciated. But let me get right into this. So the class setup I'm going to be using is going to be the ASM1 Magnitude. So it's going to be it's just a normal ASM1. You get it out of the box, but it's a slight variation. It has increased range. You guys can always go for the Elite one if you guys want, but in my opinion, I have the ASM1 Strider, but the accuracy is -3, so for me, it has like a shit ton of recoil, so I like to stick with the ASM1 Magnitude. That's the only other one I have. If I get another one, maybe it'll be better, but the three attachments that I think work best on the ASM1 are going to be the Extended Mags, Advanced Rifling, as well as the Foregrip. Now, the extended mags on this submachine gun is absolutely insane. If you put the extended mags on the ASM1, you get 67 rounds per clip. That's insane. You don't have to reload for like 5 kills if you have good enough aim. I mean, you might have bad aim, but if you have good aim with the ASM1 and you have 67 bullets per clip, you're going to be an absolute monster. And I fucking love it. I could not love it anymore. It's just perfect. And then I have advanced rifling on. Of course, advanced rifling just increases your range a little bit, and it makes it a lot easier for submachine guns, because submachine guns did get buffed, but they still don't have the range of assault rifles, so advanced rifling definitely helps. It's way better than a suppressor, guys. Trust me, do not put a suppressor on. It will weaken the gun, and it won't be good at all. And then, last but not least, I have foregrip on there because it does decrease the recoil a lot. Now, I have the grip on pretty much every gun in this game because reduced recoil in this game is great. It's perfect because people are everywhere. It's really chaotic as it is. You do not want to throw recoil into the mix. So foregrip, advanced rifling, and extended mags is my perfect setup for the ASM1. Now, the perks that I'm going to be running are low profile to stay off UAVs, of course, because UAVs are a lot easier to get now that the patch came out. Next perk is Blind Eye. Now, Blind Eye is kind of controversial with peripherals. Now, Blind Eye, the reason I run it is because, like I said, since the patch, streaks are a lot easier to get. So, I find that Blind Eye is very helpful for staying off the radar from, like, Warbirds and Paladins and all those other streaks that could see you. I think it's very useful because I hate dying off of one of those streaks that somebody randomly gets either from a care package or because they, you know, just fucking cap whore. So, you know, I hate dying off streaks like that. So Blind Eye is definitely the best perk to run for this class setup. Now, my perk 3, I have the wild card for 2 perks. I have Scavenger and Blast Suppressor. Scavenger is up to you. You guys can run toughness if you want. Like I said, there's 67 bullets per clip, so you might not need Scavenger, but I personally prefer it just because I hate running out of ammo on a long streak. It pisses me off. And then Blast Suppressor over Toughness because, you know, Blast Suppressor is key. You need to stay off the radar whenever possible. And then I have the Exo Launcher. I have the Semtex because, you know, grenades are very useful in some situations, and I find myself needing it a lot. So I think it's very useful. I wish Scavenger replenished it, but however, it doesn't. So going on to my 2 score streaks, I only run the System Hack and the UAV. Not both of them. The System Hack has the, I believe it has the flash as well as the assist. So I get assist points and I get a little flash. That's very useful. And then UAV, I have the threat detection and assist. So both give me assist points. Very useful. I love it. And threat detection is amazing. It's like the Oracle. It's very, very, very useful, guys. So that's pretty much all I wanted to talk about. Don't forget to leave a like. Let's try to hit 50 likes on this video, guys. I'm Rocky Cinema. You can just call me Hyper Rockies, and I'm out for the day. Peace.